Will Brunsford, my third cousin, was lead guide, very popular. So Judge Jennings says, Will, we're going to represent at the 1893 World's Fair in Chicago, and I want you to thank things from the cave up there. Will was charged to go into the cave on the other end and take gypsum flowers and artifacts and a little slave girl, a little Native American girl named Little Alice in a wooden case to the 1893 World's Fair in Chicago. Daddy said he caught the train right here. So he gets aboard his train, and Will knew that he could pass for white. Will says he gets to Chicago, and when the train crosses the Ohio River, head north, Will says, I want to get up front in the all-white car. He said, those folks up there didn't know I was a man of color, and I never told them. When a conductor came by and took the tickets, I just sat there. So I rode all the way to Chicago, and they never knew I was a man of color. He said, I just kind of wondered what it felt like to ride up in that all-white car, you know. So he was up there for 5 months representing Mammoth Cave. If you go to Chicago to the Columbia exhibit, you can still see the things that was taken up there in 1893 for the World Fair. So Will came back to Mammoth Cave. Again, he rode in the old white car until the train reached Louisville, Kentucky. So he says, when the train stopped to get water for the boiler, I took my proper seat in the car of the train where people of color were supposed to sit. So when I got back to Mammoth Cave, I told folks up on the ridge that I went to Chicago, I represented Mammoth Cave, but the most interesting thing I did was riding that all-white car. I wondered what it would feel like to ride up there, and I did. They didn't know it to the day that I ever did that. That's a true story.